Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. Next in the Vue.js series, we're gonna learn about Vue lifecycle hooks. The lifecycle hooks are the predefined methods which get executed in certain stages of the Vue object lifespan. Starting from the Vue.js object initialization to when it gets destroyed, the object follows different phases where Vue.js hooks are executed. In the official Vue.js documentation, here is the lifecycle diagram of Vue.js. In this diagram, you can see when Vue.js is initialized, then it performs some operations. And these red boxes are the hooks which is executed at certain stages of this process. This before create hook is executed when the Vue.js object is initialized and creating an object. And this created hook is executed when the object is created and ready to communicate with DOM. This before mount hook is executed before rendering into the DOM, and when it is rendered, this mounted hook is executed. Similarly, when the data is updated in the component, this before update and updated hooks are executed. This before destroy and destroyed hooks are executed when the object is removed from the DOM. Let's see these hooks in the code. So here I have created this message component. And in the app.view, here we have imported that message component, and here we have printed that. This message component accepts the message probe and it is printed here. Now let's create all the hooks. So first is before create, and here I'll say console log before create. Similarly, we call another hook created. And here we console log created. Next hook is before mount. Another hook is mounted. Next is before update. Updated. Before destroy and destroyed. Just forget to change the console logs. Now remember these methods are the predefined in the Vue.js. You can find it in the Vue.js source code. These are the reserved methods by Vue. Now if we go to the browser, let's open the inspect tool, console, refresh. Now here you can see this before create, created, before mount and mounted hooks are executed. And you can see I didn't do anything. It automatically executed at the specific stages in the component lifecycle span. And you can also notice the order of these methods. Before create is executed first when the object is initialized and creating the object. And when object is created, this created method is executed. And when it is about to render in the DOM, before mount is executed. And after rendered into the DOM, this mounted method is executed. Now you can notice these methods are not executed. This before update and updated method will execute when it changes its data. Let's try out. So let's say here we have data property. And it returns title. Let's wrap this into the div tag. Now here we have input type text v-model is equal to title. Let's see this in the browser. Now here you see, as I type in this input field, you can see this before update and updated method executed. So on change data in the input field, it is executing before update and updated. Next, these two methods will execute when the component is removed from the DOM. So how we gonna implement this? So here in the parent component, let's say here we have button, let's say hide message, and at click let's say show message is equal to false. Next, here I'll add data property and it returns message initially it is true. V-F show message, refresh. Now here when we click this hide message button, this component should remove from the DOM, and here we should see before destroy and destroyed method executed. Let's see this, and here the component is removed, and here in the console we have before destroy and destroyed method. In real life project, there is very rare chance that you will need all these hooks. Mostly I use this mounted hook because it is executed when the view component is ready and rendered in the DOM. I want to show you one more way to execute these hooks. Let's see this. Let's remove all of these from here. Now from the parent component, we want to execute hook for this message child component. So for that, here we say at hook colon then hook name, let's say created is equal to then the method which we want to execute. Let's say message is created. Now here we'll create this method. Console log created for message component. Now in the browser, refresh, and you can see created for message component. That is very rare case when you will need that way. Mostly you will use created mounted hooks in the component. This is all in this lesson. If you like the video, hit the like button, share this video, and don't forget to subscribe us. See you in the next video.